So hey there, this is Ayush and today we will learn how to design a servo motor mounting block for a ball screw linear actuator. And the challenge is we have to design a servo motor mounting block in a way that can align the servo motor shaft with the ball screw shaft within 250 microns. Otherwise, our servo motor coupling could be damaged, that we have discussed in the previous part of the series. And just for a quick recap, as far in the series, we learned how to make the selection of ball screw. Then we choose the bearing arrangement for the ball screw. And then we learn how to make the selection of correct motor sizing. And on the basis of motor specs, we learn how to make the selection of a perfect coupling. So let's start the designing of motor mounting block. So here we are in SolidWorks. If you want to follow me along, you can download all the CAD model from video description. So let's first bring the coupling into the assembly. So go to the insert component and select the coupling. And now just roughly assembled it. And now let's talk about what are the mounting option for this motor. The first option we have, we can design a motor mounting plate something like this. And here we can easily maintain the center height of the motor shaft from the base. But there is a problem. We cannot maintain the lateral misalignment with that block. Why? Because this fixed bearing block generally not comes with dowel pin. We can make the dowel pin in this motor mounting plate, but we should not make the dowel pin within this bearing unit because this is a standard part. However, we can make a slot here, a slot cut here, and we can fix this bearing block within the cut. Also, to align the lateral misalignment, we have to add the dowel pins in the motor mounting plate. And after that, we have to precisely machining this base plate. And we have to maintain the close tolerance relation between this slot cut and this dowel pin position, which is a critical machining process. Also, we have to maintain the close tolerance relation between the dowel pins and the motor guiding step. And overall, this machining cost will be higher. So let's talk about second option. And in the second option, we will replace this bearing block, this foot mounting bearing block, with a flange mounting bearing block. And in that case, we have to design a block, not a plate. And after that, we will make a cut here for the coupling assembly. And then we can make a through all holes at the both side. And at the one side, we will assemble the flange type fixed bearing block. And at the other side, we will assemble the motor. And we can put our ball screw. And then we can assemble our coupling. And the benefit of doing this is we can easily maintain the alignment between ball screw shaft and the motor shaft with only a single block. And the maintaining the close tolerance relation is way much easy. We can machining these two holes in a one set of machining. And we will able to maintain all types of misalignments. And this is my personal choice. But again, this is up to you. Either you want to go with the foot mounting support bearing unit, or you can use this kind of flange mounting bearings. And you can also purchase the motor mounting and the bearing mounting blocks as a standard item. And as I have changed the support bearing unit, we have to check ball screw bearing seat's dimension. So let's check it by the cross section view. And in this bearing block, the bearing seat length is larger. So let's measure it. And the bearing seat length plus the spacer length from outer spacer to the inner spacer, the distance is 60 mm, so we have to change the step length. So just double click on it and take it to 57 mm, or we can go for 58 mm. If you are wondering why we are not taking 60 mm or more than the 60 mm, you can watch the previous video of this series. And now go back to the assembly, and here everything is okay. And now let's design this motor mounting block. This design is just for demonstration. So here I'm deleting this. And let me take it to top view. So here we will design our block something like this. And then we will make a through hole here to guide the motor. And also here we will make a through hole to guide this flange type bearing unit. And now let's talk about the dimensions. So the motor width is 80 mm and the bearing block flange width is 79 mm and the length of guide step of the bearing block is 30 mm. So let's consider the thickness of this side is 30 mm and we can also consider the same thickness at the motor side just for the symmetrical look. And because the flange width is 79 mm, so let's consider it 90 mm. It's up to you. We will adjust it later, optimize it later. Also, I am considering the width of this cut is 90 mm. Try to make symmetrical cuts. And the wall thickness, we can consider it 20 or 25. Because we have to add the mounting bolts here. And the mounting bolt size, I would like to take it to M10 or M8. So there should be enough space. So if we will add the all the dimensions, the width of block become 140 mm. And the height of the block will become 150 mm. And now let's try to create this part. So go to the new part. Go to the sketch and select front plane. Go to the rectangle tool and select center rectangle tool. Start from the origin. Go to the smart dimension and set length to 140 mm and set the height to 150 mm. Now close the sketch. Go to the feature. Go to the extruded boss. And now what about the thickness? So the height from base plate to the motor top is 88 mm. So we can set thickness to 88 mm or 90 mm. Now again go to the sketch, select the sketch, select face, go to center rectangle and start from origin. And now go to the smart dimension and set the cut size 90 by 90. And close the sketch, go to the feature and go to the extrude cut and set it to through all and hit OK. And now we have to make the motor guiding hole. So go to the sketch and select this face and select center line and start from the origin and go to the circle and start making a circle here. Go to the smart dimension and the motor guiding step diameter is 70 mm and set diameter of 70 mm and set center height, and the center height of ball screw from the base plate is 48 mm of 48 mm. Now just close the sketch, go to the feature, go to the extruded cut and change it to blind and cut it to 30 mm and hit OK. And now we have to make the guide hole fixed type bearing unit, and the fixed type bearing unit guiding step diameter is 63 mm. So go to the sketch, select this face and change the visibility to hidden line and go to the circle and start from this circle point. Go to the smart dimension and set the diameter to 63 mm. Hit OK, close the sketch, go to the feature, go to the extruded cut and the depth is 30 mm which is OK and hit OK. Now just change the visibility and now we can set the material. So select the material and set it to mild steel. Now just save it with name of motor mounting block. Close the part and bring that motor mounting block. So go to the insert component and select motor mounting block and bring it into the assembly. And here we have to remove the temporarily mat. So select the motor, go to the property manager and select all the mats, right click on it and delete it. Yes to all. And now go to the mat select the step and select the step of motor mounting block and hit OK. And now just try to mate it. So go to the mat, select the mat and mate this with the face. And also we can make them parallel. And again do the same at this side. So just select the bearing block and go to the mat property and select the all the mats and delete it. And again go to the mat and select the faces and concentric it and select this face and this face and hit OK. Now we can just remove the degree of freedom by parallel it and hit OK. And now we have to rest this mounting block on the base plate. So go to the mat, select base plate face and the motor mounting face, resting face, and hit OK. And again select the bearing step and also in the bearing unit and concentric it and hit OK. And now just mate faces and hit OK. And now we can set the coupling. So just let me take to the cross section view. And this portion of coupling is the clamping unit at the both side. But as we can see, this is fine. The step length of ball screw is fine, but the motor shaft is shorter here. So what we can do? We can reduce the size of motor mounting block. So first measure it. So go to the measure and select the face of motor shaft and select this face of the coupling and the gap is 1.8989, which is approximately 2 mm. So we have to decrease the length of this block. So just double click on it and minus it by 4 mm because this block is symmetrical. So when we will minus 4 mm, 2 mm will be reduced from this side and 2 mm will be reduced from this side and hit OK and just rebuild it. This is perfectly fine. And now just exit the section view, but this motor mounting block is going outside. Why? Because this mat has been removed. So go to the mat and mate it. And now this is perfectly fine, but this is extra. So just measure it and this is 17 mm. So what we can do? We can just reduce the size by 17 mm and rebuild it. But where is the coupling? And now we have to mount this motor mounting block to the base plate. So just open it. Go to the sketch, select the sketch and select the top face. Go to the rectangle tool and select center rectangle tool and start from the origin. Go to the smart dimension and set gap of 15 mm because this block is 30 mm. And also we can set this dimension to 15 mm. And now close the sketch, go to the feature. Go to the hole wizard and select counter bolt and in counter bolt select the bolt type socket head cap screw and select size of M10 and set the end condition to through all and go to the position, select the 3D sketch and just locate the points, just locate the corners and hit OK. And here the bolt length will be too big. So what we can do, we can just edit the feature and pull this bar down and check head clearance and here set it to 10 mm or we can even go more, but 10 mm is okay and hit OK. And now the length has been reduced somehow. After that we can just hide the sketches and also we can add the radius in corners. So go to the fillet and select the corners. I'm setting the corner to 5 mm. It's up to you. Also we can add some chamfer. So go to the chamfer and select the edges, outer edges, and set it to 3 mm. Also, we can chamfer the holes. So select the edges and set it to 1 mm. And now go back to the assembly. And this is perfectly fine. But here is the thing. This flange should not be over the fillet. Otherwise, it will not make contact with this face. I hope you get my point. And now we have to make the threaded hole. So we can mount this motor with this block. So just select the block, press and hold the control button and select the motor. Right click on it and select isolate. And the distraction has been added. Now just select the part and edit part. And now first we have to save this assembly. So select save and continue. And let's save it with linear actuator design. And go to the sketch, select the sketch, select this face. Go to the rectangle tool, select the corner rectangle tool. And start from this corner to this corner. And close the sketch, go to the feature, go to the hole wizard. And select the threaded hole. And the motor mounting clearance hole is 7 mm. So we have to use the bolt size M6 and select M6 into 1 and change it through all to 20 mm. 20 mm is the hole depth and select thread depth to 16 mm. Now go to the position, go to the 3D sketch and just mark the points and hit OK. And now exit the isolate view and we have to mount this bearing block also. So just select it, isolate it, go to the sketch, select the part, edit the part, go to the sketch. And now we have to mount this block to the base plate. So select the base plate and go to the edit part, go to the sketch, select this face, go to the rectangle tool, select the corner rectangle tool and start from this point to this point, exit it, open the part, go to the feature, go to the hole wizard and go to the threaded hole and set it to M10 and go to the position and just mark the position and hit OK. And just hide the sketch and back to the assembly. And now we have to add the linear motion guides. So in the next part of the series, first we will learn how to make the selection of linear motion guide. And then we will try to assemble the linear motion guide into our ball screw linear actuator system. And next part is on your screen or you can check the description also. Thank you very much for the watching.